These are our tops of the plates. So we've got plank 1, 2, 3. This gives us plank 8 here, 7, 6. If we come another 2 1/4, that gives us plank 5, and then plank 4's 3 1/2. But that's on a much flatter section of transom. So that's reasonable. So we've got a thin piece of plywood that we've roughly fitted to the keel previously. Nailed the two lengths together to give us our length in one piece. We'll just clamp that up in place. Have a fiddle around at the front end and then mark off our widths that we've almost decided on. Then lay it on what will be our garboard plank, mark it out, stick a batten round and just see what sort of shape we're developing out of it. We've got a couple of choices with this really, depending a little bit how it's fitting against the keel further back. Because it's a bit short on the front here, we can either shave a few bits off and tap it forward and get it sitting in the rebate well, or we can just stick on a couple of glue sticks to give us those points as we come up. The other thing that happens, of course, is the more this end is forced down, the closer it gets to fitting, and the tighter in this edge goes. If we let this lift and come off, you can see this edge curls out. If we push down on the very front, this edge goes in. So quite how our plank is going to react when it's steamed in is always a bit of a stab in the dark. The one thing we must do, we've roughly cut our rebate there, but it's not as deep as it's going to end up. And so our whole plank is going to fit in further. But we want to cut it with a bit to spare just so that we've got wood there so that we can trim it, fit it, and get it fitting nice and tight all the way along. I'll just see how this is fitting in under here. It's fitting quite well at the back. I'm running along the keel, so it's really just that front third of the boat we need to check on. And whether you can pick up, because we planed the bevel on our hog fairly well, when our plank goes in there, it fits really well on that inside edge, but also by trying to push in the inner edge, we know that bevel's right, and it's not, the plank isn't just riding on the outside edge of the hog. So we need to make a little bit of a decision about how tight our top edge is going to be there. And I think from the looks of that, we just need to shave a bit more off down here so that this plywood will sit in the rebate. That'll give us a nice shape coming up to the stem there. Our plank may not be this whole width. We may end up bringing it down to here somewhere. But that's a nice steady curve and twist back to the first mould. That's not a bad shape on the plywood. I've left it slightly big there because we've still got a bit of rebate to chisel out into the stem. So the thing to do really now is just make some notes on our template of the widths we want, where we want them. And then we can lie it on our spruce plank and see what it looks like. I think here on the stem, we probably want that to be the lower edge of our next plank. So that plus the overlap, we're looking at that sort of width there. Go back to the middle mould, where we previously marked out the sort of widths we were estimating. And we can see there, we're looking at 5 inches. So we want 5 inch width on our pattern there. And now at the transom, here we've got our pattern and our estimate of plank widths on the transom. And we can mark directly onto the pattern there. So that's that. What we'll do, we'll whip our template off, stick it on our piece of spruce, put some battens around it and just see what it looks like. So here's our spruce plank, it is a lot longer and a lot wider than we actually need. I'm hoping that any offcuts from it might maybe be used somewhere else in the boat, either for stringers or... I always try and get the best planking I can, and this is Canadian spruce, which has been selected for its grain orientation. It's effectively quarter sawn timber, whether it was quarter sawn or whether they just selected the boards with the best grain, I don't know. There's our plank, and we've sort of got two choices of grain orientation really. We can have the grain like that, or we can have the grain like that. Now, when a tree is sawn up, depending where the board comes from, gives us our grain orientation. If the log is just sawn through and through, like that, into big wide planks, then these are the sort of pieces of wood we get. Apart from a couple of planks near the middle, these here, where the grain is across the width of the plank. If we've got a tree there and it's quarter sawn, there are several different ways of doing that, but essentially what happens is the tree gets cut there, then it gets cut there, and then boards are cut off like that and like that and like that. So that most of the wood, most of the timber that comes off, has got this sort of grain pattern on it. As far as planking a boat goes, if we use this sort of grain direction for planking the boat, when the wood got wet or when it dried out, it would swell and shrink along these lines. So this plank would end up badly cupped as it shrank, or when it got wet, became swollen, it would go the other way. And on a clinker boat, that really leads to problems. There's a lot of movement width-wise, and so you end up with the nails, copper nails, being stretched because the copper's soft. And then after a few years, you end up with a leaky boat that is a real struggle to keep watertight. Using planks with the grain like this, there's the same percentage movement, but obviously if this is only 10 millimetres across and it's a 3% movement, our plank thickness is altering very slightly. Whereas here, if it's 100 millimetres that way, we're looking at maybe up to 2 or 3 millimetres of actual movement in its width. So this is the sort of grain you need to aim for to plank a clinker boat. Now we can just carry through that mark, which was going to be the top of our garboard plank, which I've marked through from the other side. It's there. Midships we've got 5 inches. Is there. We're looking at 3 inches there, so I'll make a note there.